What you got to say, Chase?
Man, this hood mixtape volume 2. Get it in over here.
Let's get it.
Let's go.
Let's get it. Hey, low and slow, low and slow. Isometric, slower.
Why so easy?
Isometrics.
Too easy.
We on the isometrics around here. Cali Polystenics around here.
How long I need to hold it down?
I think of one thing and one thing only. I think about a call I got 2 weeks ago from my little brother. Little brother's name is Chase. And my little brother called me on the phone. And you know, when you talk to somebody, you can hear that they got that lump in their throat because they was probably crying or something like that. I heard that lump in his throat. And he said, Kai. I said, yes. He said, I made it. Now, what he was talking about, he's talking about the fact that he walked on at the University of Texas. And that's been his dream school since he was 8, and he was illiterate. He didn't learn how to read till the 3rd grade. He said, I want to play at Texas before he could even spell Texas. That's why he had that lump in his throat when he said, I made it. So I called him back a little bit later when he was a little bit more calm. And I said, Chase, man, bro. That's all I said was Chase, man, bro. And what he told me, he said, man, how it happened is there was a tryout. 42 people out there for 5 spots. People that probably had the inside scoop on knowing the coach, they're probably from the Chase from Compton. He's not from Austin, Texas. The people that already knew somebody to help them get in and get an advantage, had a teammate on the team and stuff like that, Chase did not care about that. That boy ran so hard that he dang near had to crawl back to his dorm. And when he got back to his dorm, he just laid down in his bed because the coaches said, we're going to let you know in 2 weeks which of you 42 made the team. It didn't take 45 minutes for them to call Chase Moore. And Chase, they called Chase and they said, Chase Moore, I want to let you know that you made the team at University of Texas practices on Tuesday. Chase said, and I quote, you don't get it. And hung up on the coach. He said, you don't get it. Like he didn't get it. He didn't understand. Chase said, you don't get it. To the coach. Coach, you don't get it. And then hung up. Because when he says you don't get it, he's talking about the fact that he was a gang member. In middle school, he was a Crip. All he did was smoke weed and ditch classes. He's talking about the fact that he has friends that are in the grave, skeleton and bones. Chase talking about the fact that all the friends, all the kids he hung out with growing up, they're all in prison. When he says you don't get it, he's talking about the fact that when he said he wanted to play at University of Texas, he could not spell Texas. So here when we I say, are. When Chase said you don't get it, Chase is talking about the fact that he did this without a father.
It's funny how
that he
so
led the city of Los Angeles
so
with 109 tackles as a free safety, and his dad has so never seen him do a backpedal. When he says you don't get it, Chase is talking about the fact that he did this without proper nutrition. I'm talking about putting that trash in your system, top ramen noodles, Kool-Aid, nothing around the house that you could really feed yourself with.
Your
but in his mind, he's envisioning a steak, lobster, shrimp. Vegetables. When he told that coach he don't get it, he didn't understand that just a year ago, Chase was a Division I laundry specialist. Now, let me explain what a Division I laundry specialist is. I don't know if anybody, you know, I don't know if you know any Division I laundry specialists or what that is, but it's really just a dude that does laundry and on work study. He went to Holy Cross before he went to University of Texas, and he played as a freshman. You know, he was good. He played cornerback. He played on some special teams and stuff like that. But then he decided, you know, you can fail at what you don't want to do. So I might as well go for what I want to do, for my dream. And he knew his dream was to play at University of Texas and make his name and make his legacy known. So he ended up deciding he was going to transfer. Now, this is such a tough thing for Chase. All those people that thought he was cute or thought he was nice or good at sports, now they didn't look at him anymore because now he's pushing the laundry. He would touch towels that had, you know, feces on it, blood on it, all types of horrible things. But he changed his mindset. He said, if I'm going to be the guy that does laundry, no, I'm going to be a Division I laundry specialist. If your ass says, hey, you got a job on campus before you transfer, what you? I'm a Division I laundry specialist. He made a business card. You don't understand. He made a business card. He made a business card. He would hand it out to people with his email and his number, and it said Division I laundry specialist on it. And one time I called Chase, and I remember I said, I heard some people in the background. He said, I'm at work. I said, for sure. I said, Chase, who's that in the background? Oh, those are my employees. Certainly they were not his employees. They were actually his coworkers. But that's the type of mindset he got. And that's from not making excuses, but making adjustments.